Thank you. How he died matters not. Gesser was a great warrior. He will return to us in time.
Not soon enough, Hartun. The Nardom is nearly upon us. Mayhap we should counsel restraint until after.
I do not understand. If Gesser is dead, how should he return?
Silence! You come to spy on us, knowing naught of our ways.
We know you are fearless, and that you are called the Undying Ones.
That is true. None are braver than the Dothal, for we do not fear death. With death, a warrior must dance boldly, fearlessly, for thus does his soul burn bright. Then, in death, his soul shines white, exalted. The flesh rots, but the soul endures. And ere the seasons have turned, so he shall return. When he is glimpsed in the eyes of a newborn, he is blessed with the same name, that he may grow into a great warrior once more.
You mean to tell me these newborn babes and fallen warriors are one and the same? Madness!
I gave you leave to observe, not to insult our beliefs. Have care what you say.
Otherwise, do as you will.
Thank you.
death for the vultures. It seems an insult to the man. But the soul lives on, they say. These bodies, no more than empty husks, returning to the earth. Seen through those eyes, I suppose the sight is almost comforting. Pardon me? When first I heard the tales, I could not help but scoff. Another queer tribe, I thought, with still queerer customs. Yet having borne witness to their rites, I cannot deny there is a certain logic to it all. A samurai will die for his lord without hesitation or regret. But this is not because he delights in such sacrifice. Because he has faith that his death will serve a higher purpose. There is an awakening in that instant. When the heart sings, and the blood burns, and his soul finds peace. There is comfort in that. We dare not permit ourselves that luxury, my friend, tempting though it may be. Not while our loved ones yet remain in chains.
Well, if there is a way out, I can't see it. Shame we didn't learn much before they locked us up.
'Tis little wonder the Orinir won the last Nardom. These people leave naught to chance.
Hien, I've had something on my mind for a while, and now... In Alamigo, where I was born, I found it strange that for all the people who supported the Resistance, there were just as many who didn't. But then we came to this part of the world and met with the Confederacy and lots of ordinary domans, and almost every single one of them seemed content to just put up with things, no matter how bad they got. They all had their reasons, of course, and it's not like I don't understand them, but... The thought of it made me so angry. After everything they'd been through, everything the Empire had done to them, how could they not rise up? How could they not fight back?
People are pragmatic creatures at heart. They hold on to hope only until they taste true hardship. Then comes fear and regret. Safer not to dream, they conclude at last. For even should a day go by without some new disappointment, the next will only bring more of the same. And so they choose the more sensible option. They learn to abide the indignities and injustices, the pain and the shame, to accept them as normal. Such is the lot of most men. One cannot expect to spur them to action at a moment's notice. But if one who has known their pain can convince them to strive for something greater and rekindle the fire in their hearts, then they will remember what they have lost and they will rise.
I had someone like that once. I didn't know who I was or who I wanted to be, and he risked his life to show me the way.
Then honor him by doing the same for others with all your might and main. You know, when my homeland fell 25 years past, I was still in my mother's womb. Never have I known a free Doma. But my father did, as did many of my fallen comrades, as do many of my people now. It may be no more than a dream to me, but if I do not chase it, then who will?
The way you carry it all, you're just the same.
Hmm? As you?
Oh, no, not me. Definitely not me. I meant the Warrior of Light. Out there, somewhere. Doing what needs to be done. I won't have you put me to shame any longer. I'm going to seize the future I want with my own two hands.